On guys, it's your boy Stan here from the Stan Gaming Network, and welcome back to Doomsnet Lab. Sorry I haven't been able to do anything for a while. I've been running into some problems with the live streaming program on the PlayStation 4. Yeah, so it wouldn't let me live stream. So anyway, I've been going back to the new to the Doom snap map, and I figured let's go back to the zombies because I never really actually figured out a working zombie mode, but I have actually kind of figured it out. A code that works for zombies here. So, of course, we got our player spawns and stuff starts here. I've coded them to each of them to be a certain player. Sorry, gotta get out of my throat. Okay, there we go. And we already got somebody watching. Okay, that's kind of cool. I gotta get the chat up first. Give me a second. But yeah, so we've got the door opening, but let me go into detail and I'll show you it off here in a second. Let's see, mouse work, thank you. Let's go to live streams, it should be up by now. Yep, there it is. Alright, open up chat. And there we go. Welcome cool kid. What's going on, bro? So yeah, I finally got it working. So this is the actual spawning system that I used for the game. This is the system that will do the wave spawns. So basically, we start out with some custom group encounters, which basically is like run 1 through 5. So like I have it set to do like 6 possessed workers, and then on the round 2 there's a little bit more. Round 3, round 4, and then round 5 is a specific round. Okay, cool. Not much going on. Same here. I've been doing a lot of trying to fix things and stuff. Oh, Honda Chick, you're right. I was trying to remember your name. So yeah, we got the round starting sound. So I have those set to play, and they have like delays on them so that they'll play at like at a time. So yeah, as soon as you enter this room, it'll start off the
warning, zombie code, zombies,
and play the sounds and stuff like that. But yeah, so here's how it starts out. Like, so I have like timers set. These are like the time breaks. Actually, I forgot to do this. Next, R-O-U-N-D. There we go. The next round, I should actually have to do these for all of them. Great. So yeah, so these are the timers that go off. It basically, every time you clear the wave encounter, it'll start a timer and for the next round. There we go. It should be easier now. That should be in the things there. Next round, this is what's gonna display every time the every time the round ends. So this is the easiest part. Like, it's really specific. It's just a group encounters at the round 5. After round 5 is where it gets complicated. You see, here's my wave counter. Basically, this is what this is basically an integer with basically that every time a round ends, it'll add 1 to this. It'll add another stuff to this, because that goes later for the demons killed segments and stuff like that. So anyway, so this is where it gets complicated. So I use a survival AI conductor, and I have it set so that when the first wave, it'll test the round, the wave counter, which is the round, which is like basically the rounds. And greater than or equal to round six, which any time it's, you know, after round 5, since it'll be round 6. So once it's round 6, any time from there, any number, if it's equal to round 6 or higher, it'll change the tier to level -1 demon difficulty. And this is a code that works. And so basically it'll continue to do that until round 10, where it'll test to see if it's greater than or equal to round 10, and then change it to 0, round 20 and higher. It's really complicated stuff. Okay, I'll keep an eye out for it. So it's complicated stuff, but it's basically how I got it to. The problem with the survival conductor I was running into is, okay, nice. The problem I was running with the survival conductor is that its difficulty goes way too fast. It keeps going way too fast, faster than it should be, and it just gets way too hard real quickly. And so this is a way to slow it down, basically depending on the rounds. So basically, it changes difficulty and everything depending on the round's number, based on this number that keeps adding every time a round ends. It's kind of cool. It seems to work fine. It really works well. Excuse me. And so here's like, and so the problem, another problem with the survival conductor is I ran into is it didn't really stop. There was no way to stop it from, you know, in the round. So I had to take a liberty and change a few things. So basically you get 25 kills per round. And I'm sure there's a way to change that over time. Like after a certain amount of rounds, you can change the amount. But for now, this is what I've gotten. Basically, the demons killed, it will look up for a value. Its maximum value is 26. So this is going to check for how many demons are killed. If you kill 25 demons, after 25 demons are killed, I have set it to kill all demons on the map, the rest of them, and basically start a new wave. And this will test again to see what round it is and what difficulty it should be set at. It's a very complex system, but it works, and that's the greatest thing ever because it took me a long time. This up here is actually the coding for the random drops. Insta-kills, nukes, MX ammo, double points. I was running into a big problem. I actually had to go through this multiple times to try to figure out the numbers to pick up. Basically, it's a random number generator. Yeah, sure. A random number generator. And basically what it picks a random number between 1 and, well, after a while, I've changed it. So after, for now, it's going to pick a number between 1 and 100. Actually, 1 and 80. That should be 100, actually. Why is it still 80? There. 1 and 100. And depending on that number, if it picks the number. That's every time it kills a demon, it picks a number between 1 and 100. If the number is 25, then that demon that you killed will drop an insta-kill. If the number is 50, it'll drop a nuke power-up. If it is 75, it'll drop a max ammo. And if it is 100, I saw something on the chat. A double points. Excuse me. So how I got these working is... So what before to get the problem was I was running into is it wouldn't spawn the power ups like actually on the zombie, well in this case, quote unquote zombie, which are demons, but you get the point. So the thing I forgot to do was you actually have to go in here and set it to the activator to demon, and then in the spawn setting on the spawn object you actually set it to spawn on the activator, which is now the demon, so it spawns on the demon you kill, which is how I fixed that problem. So it's going to spawn this package, and inside that package, it will have a human skull symbol. And once you pick up it, it's going to display a message, in this case, insta-kill. Run an AI iterator, and for each AI, apply a buff of 1% health. Basically, it's going to nerf him down to 1% health, so that every time if you hit him, or you shoot him with any gun, or melee them with any melee, it'll kill them instantly, and stuff like that. How I got this to stop is an integer comparer and stuff like that, depending on 1 and 2. It'll switch it between 1 and 2, and depending on whether it's 1 or 2, depends on whether it'll apply the buff of insta-kill buff or the normal health buff. It sounds confusing, but it really isn't. It's really kind of cool. The nuke power-up is based off of... it'll basically do the same thing as this one, except instead of a human skull, it'll drop a burst shell. Which just looks like this. the thing does nothing. It's just an item that once you pick up the item, it'll actually trigger the effects. The actual item itself does not actually have the effects inside of them. It's just something you pick up. But it just triggers the effect. It's like an illusion. Basically, the nuke basically set up the same way I did the round end system. Is it just for every AI, once you pick it up, it'll start the iterator. For each AI, it'll just kill every AI on pickup that's on the map. And also add a player resource value of 4,000 points, just like the original nuke, which is the player resource down here. Now you'll see some extra things in the player resource, different than when I did the tutorial on it. There's a reason for that. That's for the double points later. For the max ammo, it was pretty simple. I just made this a simple cube, like a box. And once you pick it up, now these timers, by the way, are for like if you don't pick it up, there's a timer to make it disappear. If you don't pick it up in 30 seconds, the item will disappear off the map and you won't be able to pick it up anymore. That's basically like how the drops, you know, how they flash and disappear system. So once you pick it up, it'll start an AI player iterator, and for each player, it'll give ammo. And it's not really max, I guess. I don't know if it's actually max. Depending on the gun, it's going to be max. It's the highest I can go. But it does it for all weapons, so whatever weapon everybody's carrying, it'll both, in both slots, it'll actually, you know, give... Matt, the 100 ammo too. So, The last one is the double points. So this was actually a tricky one to figure out. See, the problem was is figuring out how to make the you get double points, which is why where this comes into play. This is actually just the normal player resource system, but added with integer comparers to do the see each one of these is like there's the normal points, and there's the double points. So every time you hit a zombie or hurt a zombie, it's quote unquote zombie. It'll give you a value of 10 points, just like in regular zombies. On double points, it'll give you 20. For every kill, it'll give you for every kill, you'll get 100. For every double point kill, you get 200. And for glory kills, which are knife melee kills, it's 130 turning into 260. So basically, it's the same system as the insta-kill. It's using integers, integer compares. So I have an integer here that can only go between 1 and 2, and depending on whether it's 1 and 2. So when you pick it up, it'll set it the value to 2, when it's normally 1. The initial value is 1, so it starts off as 1. So I told this, if it is equal to 1, then to give 10 points, 100 points, and, you know, so on, the normal amount of points. If it is not equal to 1, so that means when this changes this number to 2, it will no longer be equal to 1, it'll be equal to 2. But it's looking for, since it's not equal to 1, it'll then choose this player resource to add, the double point player resources. It sounds confusing, it really isn't, once you get down the schemes of things. So, basically it's just each one of these is checking to see if it's 1, if not, then give double points. So how to make it go back was, after a certain amount of time, I said 30 seconds is the length of the double points. It'll set it back to 1, thus turning it back to the original value of points. It sounds confusing, but it's really not. It's actually kind of simple in the grand scheme of things. It just sounds difficult. This is the player cash system for when you spawn and join the match. You know how, like, in zombies, when you come in late, you get a 1,500 points? Well, that's what this is for. It decides whether to give the player 500 points or 1,500 points, depending on the round. So if it is round 5 or higher, it'll start to give players 1,500 points once they are revived, once they come back in the game and stuff. Now, I haven't got a death system worked out yet. I haven't done the death system or the regenerated health system. I haven't done those things yet, but I plan on doing those later. But yeah, this is actually the mystery box system. This is all the code that goes into the mystery box. This is the random number generator mystery box. I this time with 10 guns inside of it. It work and player resource. It makes you spend the player resource of 950. Power switch, which turns on these other doors that are actually buyable as well. As you can see, they have a buyable system here. This door is actually just 1,500. Excuse me. And also turns on these volumes for the perk machines. Juggernaut was pretty simple. I just set a modifier to increase the value, double the player's health. Double tap is basically just barrel damage is increased to the double percentage. Excuse me. Depending on the player who bought it, of course. Sorry. Speed cola. Stamina up is increase the player's speed to 150%. Speed. This actually could. I couldn't work out a quicker reload because there's no reload in Doom. There's no actual reload. So I came up with something else called clip capacity, and I named the perk ammo up. Basically, it just increases the amount of bullets you have. Mule kick was easy. I just changed the once you purchased, it'll give you maximum slots of 3, and of course, once you die, it'll reset the value to 2. It'll give the original loadout that you had on map start. This one's gonna be extra life once I finish it. I have to work out the life system. I don't know how to do this. I don't have 4 players playing with me, so I can never test out like co-op statistics and stuff. So I never get to do that, unfortunately, and stuff. So that's that. These will give you extra health and extra armor. So that's basically that. So that's basically the system I worked out for the zombies. I'm still finishing it up. And once I'm done with this, I will give the code in the I'll show it off, and in that video, I'll leave a description with the code in the description of the map, so you guys can come and reference this at any time. So without further ado, let's actually show this off. Hopefully, nothing gets corrupt while I do this, because like I still get corruption issues on SnapMap. It's after a certain amount of time, it'll just quit the game. It'll just say it's corrupt and close out, make me close it out. I can restart it and go back into it, but it's just, it's really dumb. Excuse me. I don't know. Hopefully it doesn't do that while we're doing this, so. So here we go. Let's check this out. I wonder if Honda Chick is still there. I don't know. Probably not. It depends. Alright, here we are. So here we go. You start off the Rift. Not the Rift. I think it's the Rift. Actually, I don't know. I forget what the name of this gun is. I haven't played Doom in a while. So we're going to start game. Here we are. As soon as I enter this room, it will trigger.
Warning. Code. Zombies.
Round one has started. There's a nuke. Yeah, it's sometimes you get. Sometimes it'll pick it the very first time. I really wish it wouldn't do that, but it depends. So wave one, as you see up there, and the zombie counter as well. I did the zombie counter as well. It gave us 4,000 points, but you know how it is. It's like in real life zombies when you, for some reason, get a gore kill that didn't get extra points, and it drops ammo and health. It's Doom. So I had to change some things because demons are harder and stuff like that than actual zombies. So there's some, you know, extra creative license here. As you can see, we have 4 zombies left. 3 zombies left up at the corner of the red box. 2 zombies left. 1 zombie left. Here's the first mystery box. Give us a BFG. Second mystery box. It was supposed to open and stuff, but for some reason it's not working. It should work. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just, it's being dumb. So. There. Here's the perk system. Let's, actually. Bye. Next round will be in 12, so let's. Hello? Oh yeah, I gotta turn on power. Da-da-da. That would make sense. There we go. Hold up. I keep forgetting which button that is. I'm trying to aim down sights like in real zombies. Like I said, I haven't played this in a while. There's no aim. Kobe! There we go. Now we can get. Now we can get our perk. I bought it. I haven't set up the sound system yet to confirm purchase, but I got it. See, as you can see, my health is now 200. Now, I think that should stay 200 if I get hurt or something. So we'll see. It is now round 3. This gun is actually OP, and glad I got it. Oh, hi. Yeah, I think I should stay. I actually stay. There you go. There we go. There's one zombie left. Okay, we're good. Round. Here's this door. There's that. And this is the end game. I have to fix that as well. There's some things I still gotta work on, but it still works. Ah. Ouch. That hurt. On Black Ops 2. I can't live stream Black Ops 2 because I'm using the PS4 to live stream right now, and my computer won't run OBS. It's just not powerful enough. I can't do a live stream on Black Ops 2 as much as I would like to. Now we start. Now this is my survival AI iterator kicking in. After round 5, it's now past round 5. Well, it should be past round 5. I don't have to count it, but that's okay. This now is using the AI spawn conductor. So, now once I put this all into an actual map, it'll be kind of cool. After, like, stuff, I just had to figure it all out. I could record, I could play it, but... Okay. Join your party tomorrow? Okay, what's your gamer tag again? Oh, insta-kill. Okay, that's not supposed to happen. Why did it kill every zombie? Okay, that's weird. Something was messed up in the code somewhere. It didn't do that last time, so that's kind of... You have to take a look at what's causing that. But yeah. Oh, it's because I hit... Oh, I get it, because I forgot. I hit 25 kills. After 25 kills, I told it to kill all zombies in the map, as you can see. Max ammo. I might actually have to do some adjustments on the spawning, because I'm starting to get a lot of drops. It shouldn't give me a lot of drops. It's only round 7, so I might have to do some adjustments on the insert. Toby! There's a nuke. Ready? Round 8. Oh, look. Double points. Cool. Oh, yeah. I forgot. Sorry. Memorizing your name. I know your names. I just don't remember them on, you know, what your gamer tags are. Because I don't see them often on PlayStation. This is actually an OP weapon. As shown, it's an OP weapon. It's not insta-killing anymore. As you can see, that guy didn't die instantly. But it is powerful enough to make him go to glory kill. Yeah, I might have to do some adjustments. Still have to do some adjustments on the, Hi. Bye. Boom. You're dead. So as you can see, it's not too bad. For Doom, it's not too bad. Several points. Round 10. Sometimes it'll spawn the occasional zombie. Oh, you gotta go? Okay, well, have a nice day. Sometimes it'll spawn the occasional zombie at the end of a round. I guess it's due to timing. It can't be perfect. It is like, well, it just changes and stuff. It's not always perfect, and I'm not smart enough to go all full in. Like, this is just knowledge that I know, and that's not knowing anything. When I first started doing Doom Snap Map, I didn't know anything. Now, unfortunately, right now, there's only allowed to be, the reason I chose 25 kills is because there's only ever allowed to be 12 demons on the map at one time. And like, it's kind of like Nocturne Totem in Old World at War, like, where you only had, like, 25, I think it was, zombies. Matt, I missed the max ammo. You saw that? It disappeared after the 30 seconds. Okay, let's get some... double damage. Did I buy that? I think I did. Maybe, I don't know. I in theory, everything should work. So. Let's... There, my keys in three. Boom! I can also carry a third weapon now. There. Also got some crystal batteries with the non-three. Okay, I'll keep an eye out for it. Honda. Oh, gun points. Yay. So now as you see, my speed is increased and my health is increased. I can't actually tell if the damage, bullet damage is increased, but it says barrel damage, so I assume in theory that should work. What up? There we go. Boom. I still have 200 health, as you know. Now when you die, in theory, I'll let myself die and just show you guys it will go back. I mean, I still gotta do the wall guns and other stuff, a few more things before I finish this. I gotta do the strings on the few boxes as well. Yeah, well, hold on. I should have... Oh yeah, I can only show two guns at a time. But as you can see, I still have my BFG. You can only, like, switch between two guns at a time. But if you wanted to get your other gun out, you just do this. See? There. There. As you can see, that works. You have three guns, so it still works. Woohoo! Max ammo. Let me try this again. I bought it, so it's... I guess it's not... It's not... Let me take it, so... I must have had it, bought it or something. In theory, it should work. Everything should be work fine. Now imagine this in an actual map, which I'll show you an example of here soon, if I don't crash first. Now, I think I put the ending workable, so... Once I finish this up, we'll show it off one more time. And stuff. It's a pretty good code. As you see, it works pretty well. Minus some, like, you know, I may need to adjust the drops a little bit, finish up on some of the wall guns, one gun configurations, but yeah. As soon as it's done, you guys can take a look at it yourself. Round 17. Ah, explosive guy. Let's actually show off some health. As you see, I'm at 165 health. I just increased my health. I'm gonna buy some armor. There, I got some armor. There you go. Nuke for 4,000 points. Okay. Nice. Trick shot. I've never been good at trick shotting myself. Kobe. That was a bad grenade. I got some money. Ooh, I think we got insta-kill, but the round ended. Don't worry, we'll have 15 seconds of insta-kill time once the round is started next. The round is started. So yeah. This is just the texture map. This is where I do all my experimenting. See, as you can see, it's one knife kills. Imps as well. Ooh, max ammo. As you can see, it's no longer it's insta-kill. Come on, wait, what? Okay, insta-kill is over. Sexy. As you can see, it's no longer insta-kill. But that was glory though, so that's... Die. I might have increased my bullet damage. I might have to work on double tap a little bit. Everything else seems to be working fine, as well as all the other perks seem to work fine. Which one? What's the context? The technical delay, so you guys have to remind me what I said. the context of that, See, as you can see, we hit 25 kills and they all die. Next round starts. I might have to increase it. It's a little too easy. I mean, for the earlier rounds, maybe not. But I think I'm going to have to figure out a way to increase the amount of zombies needed to be killed before the round ends. And at a certain thing. I'm trying to figure it out. I figured out how to make a zombie work in zombie code, so... Kobe! I hope I can get Doom Campaign working again. If I can, that'd be great, but let's finish that. Double points. Yeah, I think, like, after round 15, we need to increase the amount of zombies a little bit. And after round 25, we'll do another increase. I think that will be good. That should be good. Yeah, as you can see, it's a little too quick for round 23. But we'll work it out. As soon as I finish, then it'll be open up to all. I've seen a lot of people make zombie maps, but the difficulty just increases way too fast. Because people don't know actually how to code the survival AI to make it more like zombies. And that's what I'm trying to do, is figure out a way to code it so it's more like actual zombies. Now, after round 25 or round 30, I think it's round 30, actually, we'll start to get newer demons spawning in, some harder demons. I figured most people get to round 30, but and that's where most people, like, taper off. Oh, you want me to, which one do you want to do? I don't know. If you want a trick shot, that's fine. I'm more into zombies, though. If you want me to join and play with you, then it's going to have to be on zombies, because I'm not multiplayer or anything like that, so. Yeah, as you can see, we have two zombies now. Three zombies. The zombie counter is working fine. You can also, I guess I could also use that to, I guess I could use the zombie counter to do, to figure out rounds. But the problem is, as I said, the survival AI doesn't, the survival AI conductor doesn't have a limit. So they'll just constantly, as soon as I get to the last zombie, it'll spawn more zombies. See, there's a new demon. It's starting to get harder now. As you can see, we're starting to get shield guys and sorts of things. Okay, you're playing by yourself, okay. Yeah, as you can see. Nuke, double points. Yeah. Alright, I think we've pretty much showed this off pretty well. I'm gonna finish the strings on here, finish up this, and everything will, and then I'll show it off one more time. But this is what I've been working on. I'm gonna definitely do a stream on, I think Doomsnap, yeah, I forgot. But yeah. Oh, there it goes.